بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. Assalamu alaikum. Hi friends, welcome to another knowledge sharing video. In this video I will show you how to configure Siemens Sematic NetScalens industrial Ethernet switches. Shortly, they are known as IE managed switches. The procedure which I will explain in this video is so simple, and you can use it to configure both Scalens X200 and Scalens X400 series industrial Ethernet switches. In this video, I will use Scalens X204-2 industrial Ethernet switch. However, same procedure is applicable for X400 series industrial Ethernet switches. There will be little bit variation which can be easily understand. To configure Scalens X204-2 industrial Ethernet switch, we need following things: laptop or any PC. In laptop or PC, primary setup tool should be installed. This software is usually delivered with Scalens X204-2 Ethernet switch. In packaging, you can find DVD which has primary setup tool as well as documentation related to Scalens X204-2 Ethernet switch. You can also download it from Siemens website. You can find link in description. For configuration, we will use web-based management, so make sure that your laptop has updated version of Internet Explorer. One RJ45 Ethernet cable for communication, 24V DC power supply. Apply 24V DC voltage to Scalens X204-2 to power on it. Connect RJ45 cable to laptop and to any RJ45 port of Scalens switch. I have connected to port 1. You can see P1 LED is switched on and it is green. New Scalens Ethernet switch which you receive from Siemens usually don't have any IP address, so we cannot able to access it with web-based management by using Internet Explorer. So it means first we have to assign IP address to Scalens. For this purpose, I will use primary setup tool. Double click on primary setup tool. When it opens, you see empty window. To bring Scalens in primary setup tool, we have to scan or browse connected network. For this purpose, I can use browse button in corner or browse option under network menu. I will click on browse button. Browse the network stations window will appear and it will start to scan Scalens switches in network. As we connected only one Scalens switch, so it will appear in left window. After Scalens X200, you can see two addresses. First address is MAC address, which you can find in front of Scalens switch. You can compare it with your connected Scalens switch to ensure that it is same. As you can see here, both MAC addresses are same, which indicates proper connection between primary setup tool and Scalens. Second address is IP address of device. Currently it is 0000, which means IP address is not assigned to device. If you click on Scalens X200, it will expand and you can see general information on right side window. Second row is showing device name, and if you click on third row of industrial Ethernet interface, here you will get options to assign IP address and name of Scalens X204-2 switch. If you have connected new Scalens switch directly to your plant network, then you can assign IP address and subnet mask according to your SCADA or DSS architecture drawing by using your engineering station. It is possible, but I will not recommend it, especially in case of plant bus, which is responsible for communication of PLCs. There will be small risk of tripping. Here I am using my laptop, so I will assign IP address and subnet masks according to my laptop network settings. Right click on network icon in system tray and click on network and sharing center. Click on Ethernet and then click on details button. Here you can see subnet masks and range of IP address of your laptop. Close network property box and network and sharing center. Come back to primary setup tool. Type IP address 169.254.239.150. Subnet masks 255.255.0.0. Assign to name to your device as per your SCADA or DSS architecture. Click on apply button. Now these changes need to download in Scalens switch. For this purpose, click on download button. Warning message will appear. Click yes to continue. After downloading, you can see changes are updated in left window. Now close primary setup tool and again open it so we can verify the updated configuration. Again click on browse button to scan Scalens switch. Scalens switch has been detected with updated IP address. Expand the Scalens X200 tree. You can see device name also updated. Now we can use web-based management through Internet Explorer to configure Scalan's X204-2 switch. I can access to Scalan switch by opening Internet Explorer and by entering Scalan switch IP address on address bar. Or you can use primary setup tool to open access page directly. Click on main Scalan's X200, then click on configuring INC modules button. Scalan switch web-based management page will open. You need username and password to access configuration parameters. By default, there are two types of usernames. One is user and its password is also user. It is only to read the configuration of switch. Second is admin and its password is also admin. It is used to read and write the configuration of Scalan switch. I will enter username admin and password is also admin. As you can see by click on I button, click on login button. In main page, you can see the status of LED lights and main menu of X204-2. Expand system menu and click on I&M option. Here you can find Scalan switch order code, serial number, hardware and software revision details. For configuration, we use save and load HTTP option. In this page, configuration file, event log and firmware file options are more important for us. If you have backup file of your previous switch, then you can easily load to new switch to configure it, and it is recommended method. For this purpose, click on browse button, select backup file and click on open button, then click on load and restart button. Warning message will appear, click OK. Now restart countdown timer will start. It is possible that after loading configuration file, now you cannot access to Scalan through web-based management system, because difference in IP or network addresses of newly loaded file in Scalan and your laptop. You can use primary setup tool again to verify that IP address, subnet mask and names are changed according to configuration file. If you don't have backup file, so I will recommend you save configuration of any other similar switch in network by using your engineering station or your laptop, then load this file to your Scalan switch. After this, change three important parameters. Change IP address by using primary setup tool. Change name of device as required by using primary setup tool. Redundancy mode, for example, is this Scalan's MRP manager, MRP client or something else. After any change, don't forget to click on set values button. Otherwise, change will not transfer to Scalan's switch. So friends, it was a simple and basic method to configure Scalan's industrial Ethernet switch. Hope you like it. If you like it, then share it to your friends. May it will be useful for them. See you in next knowledge sharing video. Till that time, Maasalama, Allah Hafiz, bye bye.